Humans are social creatures, and comparisons to others can affect our behavior and actions. This often takes the form of comparing relative quantities. For example, comparing your income against that of your friends and acquaintances. But are we also influenced by ordinal rankings? Ignoring cardinal differences, does the mere fact of being ranked first versus third versus fifth matter? This paper studies that question in the context of education. Using administrative data from England, the authors ask whether a student's class rank in primary school has a lasting impact on their secondary school performance. Several aspects of this setting are worth highlighting. First, the data are comprehensive, encompassing 5 cohorts of the entire English state school population. This amounts to almost 2.3 million students attending 14,500 different primary schools. Second, students are required to take national exams in science, math, and English at the end of primary school at age 11, and again in secondary school at age 14. The paper uses these scores to measure secondary school performance, while these scores are used to calculate each student's subject-specific class rank in primary school. As primary schools are small, students in the same school subject cohort group are considered a class. Finally, there is a substantial amount of remixing between primary and secondary school. The average primary school sends students to 6 different secondary schools, and the typical secondary school receives students from 16 different primary schools. This means that students in secondary school have a new set of teachers and peers who are unaware of their primary school ranking. To estimate the causal effect of rank, the authors use variation across classes to compare similar students with different rankings. Because classes are small and students vary in their ability, students with the same test scores can have different ranks depending on which class they attend. To illustrate, suppose this is the distribution of scores in Class A, while this is the distribution in Class B. Because these are different, 2 students with the same test score can have a different class rank. Here, the purple student has a higher rank than the green student. This gets us part of the way, but to ensure that scores are comparable across classes, the authors additionally de-mean scores at the class level. Thus, the analysis compares students in different classes who have the same score relative to their class mean, but different rankings due to the different class-level distributions. In this example, 2 classes have the same mean, but different variances. So, while these students have the same absolute and relative score, the one in the low variance class has a higher rank. This figure shows how this strategy translates to the actual data. These 6 primary school English classes have the same minimum, maximum, and mean test score in the age 11 English exam. And while these highlighted students all have the same absolute and relative to the class mean score, their class rank ranges from 0.83 to 0.94 due to differences in the class level distributions. Thus, the authors can compare students with similar academic achievement but different class ranks. And they find that students achieve higher scores in a subject throughout secondary school if they had a higher rank in that subject during primary school. A 1 standard deviation increase in rank is associated with an increase in later scores of 0.084 standard deviations. This is comparable to the estimated impact of being taught by a teacher who is one standard deviation better than average. Interestingly, the effect of rank on academic performance is essentially linear through the rank distribution. The results are not just driven by students who rank at the very top or very bottom of their class. Beyond academic achievement, rank also affects what students specialize in at the end of secondary school. Being top-ranked in a subject in primary school, rather than at the median, increases the probability of specializing in that subject by 20%. This is important as these decisions have long-lasting consequences. The choice of specialty subjects determines what degree courses students can take in university, and these effects contribute to the gender gap in STEM. Finally, are some students more sensitive to rank than others? This figure shows the relationship between rank and academic performance separately for male and female students. Boys are more positively affected by having an above-median rank, but are marginally less affected by having a low rank. Similarly, low-income students, as proxied by eligibility for free school meals, benefit more from high ranks and are less affected by low ranks. And so, this paper finds that after controlling for cardinal achievement, a student's ordinal rank affects their future performance. Evidence from survey data suggests this is driven by student confidence. Being highly ranked among peers increases a student's confidence, thereby improving their performance. Note, this doesn't imply that parents should choose their child's school purely on the basis of rank. But it helps explain why many papers have found minimal benefits on the margin from attending selective schools. The potential benefits of these institutions may be lessened if students are placed in a peer group where they have a lower rank and, therefore, lower confidence. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. These include papers on peer effects, those studying status concerns, and finally, research on how rank affects other outcomes, such as well-being and job satisfaction.